film companion is on the sets of Lucknow Central that stars Farhan Akhtar. And today is the last day of shoot and I've got producer Nikhil Advani to take us for a tour of the film set before they break all of this down tomorrow. So come, let's go check it out. Tell us a little bit about what today's shot is.
The character that I'm playing is he's a musician who has this dream of having his own orchestra. You know, it's not really called a band where he's from. Mere khud ka orchestra hona chahiye. So that's his dream. But anyway, there are certain circumstances that bring him here. Here he meets a couple of people and there's a certain thing of rehabilitation that happens with music. He's helping around, putting together a band and doing things, and this is one moment he's gotten to himself, which is a slightly upper moment in the film, A Happier Time, where he's just sitting and singing a song and everybody joins in. It's a nice song, no?
It's a really nice song. It's a earworm. I mean, I can find myself actually humming on the way out of right, here
nice,
as well.
Yeah. But when you cross the gate, stop. So that nobody hears
wait
you.
Wait till release.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
You know, we often meet
actors. Suddenly we had a ringtone with this song in your voice.
We often meet actors only during the promotion of the film. So it's really nice to actually meet you guys while you're shooting and while you're in character.
Right.
What do you do to get into the headspace of a character, this one in particular?
You know, actually now it's really you arrive and you just feel it. You know, I mean,
is it as simple as that?
I'm talking about on this day, day 40.
Okay.
You know,
you become the character.
By now when you come here, you know exactly, you know, because you've just lived in this place now for quite some time. So you've gotten a sense of what it is you're doing. But initially, I mean, of course, I mean, you have a director, you have the writer who was here for the first week.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of conversation happened in terms of just setting a pitch, you know, for the character. I think that's more important because, I mean, all the emotional kind of experience to every dialogue or to every thing that needs to be felt will have to be brought by you.
I know we're going to have to let you go, but this is the last day on this set. So happy,
right,
sad emotions. Is there a favorite place that you have somewhere here? It feels like home almost.
You know, yeah, I mean, it does. You know, and this courtyard, of course, is the, I mean, wherever you can see the sky from. I mean, that's a prisoner's greatest joy,
yeah,
is to be able to look at the stars and look at the sky.
Sound.
Well, this is Lucknow Central Jail. The most 90% of the film is based inside this one particular set, and so I'll take you inside. Come inside. So yeah, so everything that you see, all the detailing, is something that they went for. Ranjit and his crew, the DOP, Amit Dada, they all went to Lucknow Central Jail.
Okay.
They actually went to the jail. So this is a true story.
Right.
So the film is a true story. It's based on certain events that have taken place and a group of life imprisonment inmates who are right now still in Lucknow Central Jail, who these guys went and met, and we are inspired from them and we've taken their story.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, so this is, I think, is Farhan's cell. So he has spent. Go inside. We'll lock you inside. See.
Oh my God.
You're locked. Now you're in jail.
I can check this off the bucket list.
Yeah, so this is Farhan and Gippy Grewal's cell. It's very, very basic. It's exactly like how it possibly is in Lucknow.
Uh-huh.
Possibly a little smaller. Possibly a little bigger than what actually the real size of the...
I love the detailing. I mean,
yeah. So this is the pump room and the place where Farhan and his five other inmates start learning music.
So this is where they form the band, is it?
This is where they form the band, yes. This is very interesting because how they design, so that's where Tushar comes in. He designs his shots in such a way that if Farhan is sitting over here, he can look at Ronit Roy, who's standing over there. Ronit's office is right on top of the back over there.
He's the jailer.
He's the jailer. So Ronit the jailer. So even Ronit can look straight down into where these guys are.
Space. Where are we going now?
So this is, what does it say?
Shauchalaya.
Shauchalaya, correct. So this is the bathroom. Right? So once again, totally built to scale and to completely, all the detailing is exactly how it is. This is where the men have their showers, to the extent that we like
this. Stickering is also for...
All everything. This is how the water comes out. There's not a shower head. It's water comes out from there. Over here, you can sit over here and you brush your teeth and whatever. So this where you are right now is the carpentry section. This is where people, the inmates
have been put to good use.
They are put to good use. So before it has been converted by the magic of Mr. Amit Ray and Shubhrata Dada. Earlier this was a sewing unit which Pandit Rajesh Sharma's character is in charge of.
Okay.
So yeah, so depending on the schedule, we go and we turn things around. It all gets done quickly. Okay. We finish the sewing unit. Isko change karo, ye karo, wo karo. Oh, it's done. Okay. Yeah.
What is the difference between, live locations versus on set? What do you prefer? Was shooting?
Well, I prefer shooting in live locations, but you can't really shoot at 40 days inside a jail. It's too restrictive. You're not going to be allowed to go into the places that you want to go everywhere.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Also, because it is 40 days that you have 40 days to shoot in one location, it makes so much more sense to build the location and build the set. So it gives control to the DOP because he wants to light it in a particular way. It gives control to your scheduling. You don't have to bother about day and night because you can recreate day at night. You know, so a lot of things are in your control, which normally you would not have.
Right.
You would not have a lot of things in your control. So yes, I think I prefer shooting in dual locations, but a film like this, I think only works in terms of efficiency because of by building a set. Hi guys, if you like this video, please subscribe, share, comment to Film Companion.